Recall that the definition of a linear transformation is follows. Say V and W are vector spaces with scalars from the same field F. T is a mapping from V to W satisfying these two properties. Now there's a notion that is very important regarding linear transformation, and it's the kernel of T. So the kernel of T, which is often denoted by ker of T, is the set of vectors that get mapped to the zero vector in W. In other words, ker of T is the set of vectors in V such that T of V is equal to the zero vector in W. Now, let's see a couple of examples of kernel. Say I have a linear transformation T given by Tx equal to Ax, where A is some m by n matrix. Then ker of T is given by the null space of A. And in previous video, the set is denoted by n of A. Now let's look at another example. Suppose that T is a linear transformation that takes real quadratic polynomials to R2 and is given as follows. So how do we find the kernel of T? Notice that the kernel will consist of quadratic polynomials. And so the kernel of T will consist of polynomials such that a plus 3c, a minus c is the zero vector in R2. And now if we look at this system, the only way that this can be satisfied is when both a and c are zero. And so what's left is just bx. So any polynomial of this form, some constant times x, is in the kernel of T.